Good morning to everybody. Students, let us move on to a very interesting but sarcastic story written by Leo Tolstoy, a Russian writer. It is Two Deer. Students, may I recall your memory to the first poem written by William Shakespeare, that is the Romeo and Juliet. Romeo, in Romeo's speech, when he looks at the beauty of Juliet, he says one word. I will take one word in Romeo's speech. This is the fourth line. Too rich for use, for earth too dear. He says, it's too rich for use. Our beauty is too rich for use, and for earth too dear. This here too dear means dear, for example. My wife is too dear to me. Say, for example, just imagine it. It is imagination, huh? My wife is too dear to me. This is one sentence. And another, the same sentence, like this one. My wife is very dear to me. These are the two sentences. I am explaining what this too dear may. Here, the author or the story writer puts an exclamation mark. Too dear, too dear. This is first one is my wife is too dear to me, and then my wife is very dear to me. My wife is very dear to me. That means very loving to me. She is very beautiful. My wife is very beautiful for me because I love her. Because she is dear to me. This one. My wife is too dear to me. That means she is very expensive. She always has her eyes on my pocket, on my purse. So she is too expensive. Here, this one. Too expensive. Is it too expensive? Because we have exclamation mark. Yes. Let me move on to next point, that is about the author. I have written here Leo Tolstoy. The full name of Leo Tolstoy is Count Leo Nikolaevich Tolstoy. Count Leo Nikolaevich Tolstoy. And then this author, Tolstoy, in very brief, Leo Tolstoy, was a Russian writer and who primarily wrote novels and short stories. Tolstoy is a master of realistic fiction and is widely considered one of the world's greatest novelist. He is best known for his two great novels. One is War and Peace. Another one is Anna Karenina. The first one is published in 1869 and this one 1877. These are the two very prominent, very famous novels, great novels of Leo Tolstoy. There are some short stories. Yes. This is about Leo Tolstoy. It is a brief introduction to the author. Then about the story. Let me come to the story. The story to the other is a parody. Parody means ridiculing, to laugh at. The parody of one of the modern systems of governance. How this modern system of governance is administering, then it ridicules, that means it laughs at the ways of punishing the criminals and dispensing, that means dealing out the justice in modern states. The story is narrated in a matter-of-fact tone, but with an undercurrent of sarcasm. Sarcasm means taunting, chuchumathu, moodalik, anukaso. He is mocking at, he is taunting at the system or the administration of the modern governments in this short story. Let me move on to the brief summary of this Two Deer written by Leo Tolstoy. Yes, this story, the Two Deer, written by Leo Tolstoy, takes place in the kingdom Monaco. Monaco is on the border of France and Italy. Monaco is a tiny kingdom. It is a little kingdom which locates on the borders of France and Italy, and then on the shore of Mediterranean Sea. Mediterranean Sea. The Monaco Kingdom, it is a tiny kingdom, and it rests in France and Italy, on the borders of, near the borders of France and Italy, and on the shore of Mediterranean Sea. This story takes place in this kingdom. Monaco is a small kingdom. Small kingdom means, I will give you some picture or description of this kingdom. What sphere, what area it has, and what population it has. It has the population of the Monaco kingdom is only 7,000. So one more question. What is the population of Monaco? This is 7,000. 7,000 population. Only 7,000 population was there in Monaco. And even if it is a small kingdom, Monaco, I have already told you, a tiny kingdom. Even if it is a tiny kingdom, it has, there is a kinglet, that is prince or kinglet. Kinglet. There is a kinglet or prince. When there is a kinglet or prince, there should have some palace and ministers, judiciary, just judiciary, like that, and the courtiers, courtiers, asthanikaru, kannada. Andre, there is, even though it is a tiny kingdom, Monaco, it is a tiny kingdom, there is a kinglet or prince. When there is a prince, there should have a palace and the ministers or prince, and the judiciary is there, courtiers are there. And surprisingly, for these 7,000 people of Monaco, there was an army also. Army. It is only about 60 men. Only about 60 men. Just imagine what type of this Monaco kingdom was there. It is a very tiny kingdom, so I have already told you. Then kinglet prince, to deal with all these courtiers, ministers, and having his luxurious lives, and judiciary, courtiers, and to feed the army, he has to have some revenue. Revenue. From which this revenue comes? Taxation. Taxation. What is that taxation? This is also one more question. Name any one of the taxes imposed by Monaco Kingdom. Now, the kinglet prince. The taxation was on tobacco, wine, and spirit. Wine, spirit, and a poll tax was also there. Poll tax. This is the tax levied or imposed on goods and services. But the revenue from these taxes was not sufficient for to deal with his luxurious life. So he wanted more revenue. What he did is, kinglet or prince, what he did is, he allowed to start or start a gaming house. Gaming house. Gaming house. Where the people play roulette. It's one type of game, roulette. And the owner of this gaming house receives so much large sum of money. That means the players, either they lose or win, the owner gets turnover or a huge sum of money. Apart from this large sum of money, apart from his profit, he pays some money to the prince. This is a special revenue. Special revenue. What was the special revenue of Monaco Kingdom is the income from the gaming house, income from the roulette. Yes, all is well in that kingdom. But an incident takes place. This, all is well, very peaceful. The kingdom was very peaceful. No any crimes, no any thefts, no any large crimes were there. But unfortunately, a crime has been happened there. What was that crime? A man commits a murder. A man commits a murder. They do not know what type of punishment has to be given to this criminal which has done a murder. All the ministers have gambled, assembled and discussed. And according to the law of, according to the constitution or the law and rules and regulations of that country, all were agreed to give this criminal death of sentence. Death sentence. Death sentence. Death sentence was mrityudanda. Shrachchedana anta karitare kannadalli. Andre death sentence. Marana dandane iru. Marana dandane andre adanage maranavanna vidisibidodu, haakibidodu. Ee death sentence. Death sentence. How it was done on those days, that means this one. Either to be hanged or to give death sentence. In those days, as my memory tells, hanging was not there, death sentence. And then, when they told death sentence has to be given for that criminal, they would have initially thought about whether this type of death sentence can be executed or not. To execute the execution, for the execution of death sentence, whether they have any machine or not. They didn't assume that one. They forget that one. So, for this death sentence, there should be a guillotine and an executioner. That means a man exposed this death sentence. How, what is the guillotine? This is guillotine. Guillotine. This is guillotine. See here. This is the head of a person, the criminal. And this is blade. And this is a table. The head of the man was put like this one, this one. And the very sharp blade cuts like this one. This is guillotine. For cutting off this head, to cut off the head from the man's body, there should be an expert. He is an executioner. Both these, the guillotine and executioner, both these were not there in Monaco kingdom. Then what has to be done? There is a hitch. There comes a trouble. Because they don't have any guillotine or this execution. So all ministers assembled. Again, commission was recalled and discussion was held. And then they requested first France. It's a republic. Republic. To send guillotine and an execution. France accepted the proposal and the cost was 16,000 francs. 16,000 francs. But to meet out this 16,000 francs, the kingdom or the prince or the Monaco kingdom has to impose more taxes on the people. But that is not so. Because the people are not ready to give higher taxes to the prince or to the government. So this was rejected. This is republican. And again they are assembled. And then they have requested Italy. Italy is the brother monarch of this one. Brother monarch of this one. Because here also Monaco, in Monaco also he is a monarch. In Italy also there was a monarch. So brother monarch. Italy was a brother monarch. So the request sent to Italy government, Italy also accepted on the cost of 12,000 francs. 12,000 francs. Even though it is lesser than France, that is 16,000 francs, it is only 12,000. That is 4,000 francs is lesser. But to meet up this expense also, Monaco Kingdom was not possible. So what has to be done there? Then, so death sentence. Again, the commission, the committee, subcommittee. Again, they called. They called, and then what has to be done? The death sentence has to be changed. Death sentence has to be changed to life imprisonment. Life imprisonment. This is the criminal should be kept in a prison. Prisoned in a cell throughout his life. This is life imprisonment. In Kannada, it is called as Jeevavadhi Shikshe. That means the criminal has to spend his life, all his life, in the cell or in the prison itself. This is life imprisonment. All have agreed, and the kinglet also, the prince has also agreed to put that criminal in the cell. This is what done. Then here one problem has been solved. I am telling you, one problem has been solved. That is, death sentence was altered to life imprisonment. That means the criminal was given life imprisonment. That means he has to live in prison throughout his life. This was the execution. This was the punishment given by the judiciary or the kinglet or the prince. The final say is of the kinglet or prince. So he was given life imprisonment. And then here again, life imprisonment means there has to be a God. And for this person, and that means for the criminal who is in prison, and for the guard who is watching this prisoner, who is watching this criminal, both should be fed by the parents. Both should be given remuneration. The guard has to give remuneration. This prisoner has to have food from palace and kitchen. ರಾಜನ ಅರಮನೆಯಿಂದ ಇವರಿಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ಊಟ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅನಿವಾರ್ಯ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ಗಾಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪೇಡ್ ಸಮ್ ರೆಮ್ಯುನರೇಷನ್, ಸಮ್ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್, ಸಮ್ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ. ಅಗೇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಹಿಚ್ ವೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಡೇ ವೆನ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಕಿಂಗ್ಲೆಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್. That means balance sheet of profit and loss account, income and expenses, accounts. He is looking at the account. He suddenly, his eyes goes on, stuck on one thing, that is 600 francs. Where the 600 francs were spent, on these 600 francs per year was spent on this card and the prison. 600 francs for such a criminal, prince has thought, such a criminal, 600 francs is much more. So he thought another way. He again summoned the ministers, again called, again set up a committee and subcommittee, and then he took a decision. What was that decision? We will deal with in the next class.